started pulling moves apart, and I have a forever theory. The Forever Posse track that is on that odd documentary, LeBron documentary.
The LeBron, okay. I know what you're talking about. Okay.
It was a really important song in 09, you know?
Well,
so
I think that was the first time Wayne and so who? It was Wayne,
Drake,
Drake,
Kanye.
Eminem,
Yep,
and
Kanye.
Kanye.
Yep.
Yeah.
So on Forever, everyone is pressing themselves to impress, right? Drake is first name greatest, last name ever, right?
Yep.
Kanye is just extra gross, statutory rape, you know. And Eminem raps as long and complicated as he possibly can, you know.
Yeah.
But Weezy is the outlier. Like, Kanye is being super gross, almost trying to out Wayne, you know. But Wayne just starts his verse, "Hello, it's the Martian." Super casual.
Yeah.
Really interesting. In the video, everyone is standing with the lights on them and they're power rapping with their hands. And Weezy is in a booth under red lighting with his arms around women, rapping smoke into the air.
Okay. Okay. You're right. I remember the video.
He says, "Life is such a fucking roller coaster, then it drops. But what should I scream for? This is my theme park." It's the perfect Wayne line. While everyone else is checking for what is cool, Drake has said he wishes Wayne did more of this. Weezy really does exist in a universe of his own, the way Prince did.
Yeah. And you got to understand at 09 as well, Drake was on, the reason Drake was on the track was this was supposed to be his like arrival, like, okay, like now he's playing, he's at the big boy table now.
Yeah. And he killed the hook.
Yeah, absolutely. That's often recognized as Drake's arrival as I said, the grown up table as well. But in 2009, Wayne was, he was arguably the top dog.
I mean, I'm glad you gave that information. It was my last thing that I wrote down here. Wayne is the only person on that song I am impressed by.
Yeah.
Because he completely disregarded all sense of peer pressure.
Right.
He didn't need this song to hit. He can just make more hits.
Right. And M was coming back.
Yes. He needed this. He needed this so bad.
Right. So he, and then Kanye, this was before what I believe it was released before Watch the Throne and Beautiful Dark Twisted Fantasy.
Right.
So Kanye was still in that.
He was hot though.
He was hot.
He was flaming hot. Like he was.
Yes.
But
he would. But. Wayne was unarguably, and I say unarguably, he was the top, he was recognized as the top dog at the time.
We should talk about that, right? Because like I think maybe like because by oh when was the duel between Kanye and 50?
That was 07.
So Kanye wins that. He is kind of the top dog, but what Wayne is, and this is one of the things we should talk about. You remember the Jay-Z versus Wayne fights like that people were having back in the day?
That was 06. That was 06.
I remember how unsettling it was to hear people say Wayne was the guy, right? And now I understand it. It's in perspective for me now, right? Because what was happening was Jay was always the sense of cool, right? Think of like the Reasonable Doubt cover, right?
Yes.
Like that kind of silk smooth, composed, calculated, like that sense of coolness was Jay.
Mm-hmm.
And that was a whole generation of people who were just this shit. Well, by 06, Wayne was that. Wayne was a different kind of cool. for a new generation, right? So instead of being the composed guy in the suit, he's shirtless and skateboarding, and he's, you know, just running a million miles an hour.
Mm-hmm.
You know, and from another world and a weirdo, and like that was the cool thing at that point. And that generation was like, Jay-Z's not cool, Wayne is cool. So by 09, I think Kanye was probably the top dog, but Wayne was cooler.
I mean, so when did I, because Carter 3 came out in 08, I believe, right? Yeah, I think it's 08.
Numbers. Jeez.
Yeah, because Carter 3 went platinum in a week. That was his big thing. But I mean.
Oh, you're right. 08. Yep.
And
yep.
Then I think, you know, they were on. Because I know that Kanye and Wayne had a couple collaborations,
right,
in that time period. But you're right. It always felt to me like Kanye was trying to impress Wayne.
Right. Graduation was a big deal.
Graduation.
That was 07, you know?
They had Swagger Like Us. I think Kanye did some production on... I think Kanye did some production on Carter 3. Barry Bonds off of Graduation.
Right.
So for me, like, Wayne was the top dog because it always sounded like Kanye, whenever Kanye and Wayne were on a project, it always felt like Kanye, even though he had Graduation at the time.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, and even See You in My Nightmares off 808. It always felt like he was trying to impress Wayne. Like he recognized Wayne as like a legit rapper. And so he was just trying to be like, oh, you know what? Look what I can do as well.
You know what? That makes sense. And I think 07 to like 2010,
mm-hmm.
Kanye West is still the little engine that could era, yes. Kanye West. We're like,
yes.
We're like, hey, good job, buddy. You beat 50, right? Like, Wayne is in a different space.
It's what you all been waiting for, ain't it? What people pay paper for, game it. They can't stain it, they want something new. So let's get reacquainted. Became the hood favorite, I can't even explain it. I surprised myself.